Turning overseas, six world powers are meeting in Vienna with Iranian officials today. It is the next stage in their negotiations over Iran's nuclear program, but many are doubtful that the talks will be successful, including in Israel. Here's Chris Mitchell from Jerusalem.
The talks will bring Iran together with the five permanent members of the UN Security Council plus Germany. Their goal is to finalize a deal reached last November in Geneva. Under that six-month accord, Iran agreed to cap its nuclear program in return to limited sanctions relief by the West. Here in Jerusalem, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu told a meeting of American Jewish leaders the interim deal has slowed Iran's nuclear program by only 4 weeks.
That's what Iran has given to the world, which means it's given practically nothing. But Iran has received a great deal. It's received the easing of sanctions. It's given 4 weeks. But it's receiving a new position in the world. It's being legitimized.
Netanyahu warned Iran's new centrifuges are 50 times faster than their old ones, and that Iran is developing ICBMs with one goal in mind.
By the way, the range is geared to Europe and soon to the United States. It's not for us. And there's only one purpose in the world to develop ICBMs. You develop an ICBMs in order to deliver a nuclear payload.
This is not a country that our government can trust.
Former Governor Mike Huckabee told CBN News, current U.S. policy toward Iran is naive.
I'm amazed of the naivete of the Obama administration when it comes to Iran. The Iranians are laughing up their sleeves, they're dancing in the streets because they're getting everything they want. Once again, this country that is not being held accountable, not only for their actions in trying to accelerate toward nuclear weaponization, but they're virtually being rewarded for the hateful, not just anti-Semitic, but anti-human rhetoric that they have tossed to not just Israel, but to the United States.
The talks in Vienna are expected to last for 3 days. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.